Hi, and welcome to our Flexitive tutorial on creating your first size. My name's Rob, and today I'm going to be taking you through all the steps you need to take to create your first Flexitive design size. In this video, I'll be covering how to create your design, how to choose between the different templates in Flexitive, including starting with a blank canvas, how to navigate the All Sizes view, adding images to your design, adding text to your design, and adding shapes to your design. Creating your design. This is the Flexitive Library UI. In this view, you'll be able to choose where you want to create your first design. This view is split into three different panels. On the far left, you'll see a list of all the folders and subfolders that you've created for your instance. If you'd like to change these, you can use the Edit option here. You can also navigate to new libraries by using this dropdown if there are additional libraries on your instance. On the right-hand side, you'll see a preview of the design you currently have selected. This will make it really easy to quickly see which design you're working on at any given time. In the center panel, you'll see a list of the designs that are in the folder you currently have selected. There are a list of filters that you can use at the top here to filter your designs based on the metadata that you've applied to any given design. You can also search for designs using the search option here. If you'd like to create a design, you'll simply enter a title for the design. In this case, we're going to call this design Celebrate Coffee. And then if you'd like, you could also add a description and/or a custom identifier. Once you've applied the metadata you'd like to start with, you can simply click Create. Templates. After you create your design, you'll be taken to the template selection screen in Flexitive. From here, you can choose to start your design either with a template or a blank canvas. From here, you can choose to either jump into your fixed sizes, responsive sizes, or social sizes for your design. For each of these size types, there is a number of default templates that you could choose to use, or a blank canvas. If you choose to start with any of these size types, you can always switch to another size type when you enter the editor. In this particular design, we're going to be starting with a blank canvas for fixed sizes, so I'm going to click that. The All Sizes view. Because I chose to create this design using a blank canvas for fixed sizes, I've been taken to the All Sizes view for fixed sizes. You can see on the right-hand side here that there's the option to switch to either responsive sizes or social sizes using these tabs. By default, I'm taking a look at the in-page landscape sizes, but I could change this to the full screen sizes if I'd like, or I could change this to the portrait sizes. If you'd like to search for a specific size, you can use these search options here. So for example, I could look for the 970 by 250 size, and that'll show it specifically in both this list here, as well as the view in the center here. If you'd like to start a size, you can either start that size by clicking on the plus button in the Create Sizes panel, or in this Sizes view here, clicking on the size you'd like to start. I'm going to be using a 300 by 250 today, so I'll simply click like so, and this will take me to the single size editor for this design. At this point, I can change the background color, which I'm going to quickly change to be a dark green. Adding images. To add an image to your design, you'll first need to add that image to your Assets panel. There are two different ways you can add an image to your Assets panel. You can either do it by uploading the image from your local computer, or by using the Pages section to bring in a global asset that has already been uploaded to Flexitive. I'm going to start by showing you how to bring in an image from your local computer files. To do this, simply click Upload Images, and then choose the image files you'd like to bring in. In this case, I'm going to bring in two different versions of a product image to my design. When uploading image assets, you can either upload PNGs, JPEGs, SVGs, or GIF files. For uploading videos, you can also choose to upload an MP4. If you are planning to use an image asset many times across a large variety of designs, such as, for example, uploading a logo to your design, you may want to upload that as a global asset instead. To do this, we're going to navigate to the Pages tab in the Assets panel and upload it as a Flexitive Design ID. To upload as a Flexitive Design ID, we're going to exit the full screen mode here and then navigate to where that global asset is stored in your design. In our case, we've actually stored these global assets in a separate global assets library, which I'll navigate to here. I'm going to navigate to the static logos folder. To bring in these two light logos, we're actually going to copy their design IDs by clicking on it and then pasting that design ID here. Then by tapping the arrow icon, it will upload that design as a global asset in this assets panel. We'll do that again for our landscape version. To add an image to the canvas, we'll first want to go back into our full screen mode. And then all you need to do is simply drag and drop that image onto the canvas. At this point, you can reposition or resize this element however you need. When repositioning an element, you'll notice that by default, the image is set to be contained within the bounding box and maintaining its aspect ratio, no matter how I resize that image. If I'd like to change where in the bounding box the image is placed, I can use this green focus icon to either move it to the left, right, or up or down in the bounding box. If you need to crop the image, you can also open the size and position panel on the left-hand side and hit fill and crop. From here, you can use that same green focus icon to choose whether you're going to focus on the top or bottom of the element. If you'd like to zoom, you can also use the zoom option here to zoom in by up to 4 times the original size of the image. This particular image is actually going to be the hero image of my design, the product image. So I'm actually going to want to leave this as set to fit. So I'll just reposition and resize this on the canvas like so. To add a global asset, you'll simply need to open the Pages option here and then drag and drop that global asset onto the canvas. By default, this will be set to stretch. If I want to set this to fit or fill and crop, I can use these options here. In this particular case, I'm going to set this to fit, set the focus to look at the far left-hand side of the element. Once you've added image assets to your canvas, you can also swap in new image assets very easily. I'll select this premium roast coffee cup here by clicking on it and go back to my images panel here. When you've selected an element, you'll see in the assets panel the option to swap asset. So if I simply hit swap asset here, this will do a one-for-one swap of what was previously this premium roast coffee cup with this new whole beans bag of beans. This will maintain any settings that you previously set on your previous element, including animations, positioning, and cropping. Adding text. To add a text element to your design, on the left-hand side of the editor, click Add Text. This will place a text box on the canvas for you to edit. By default, it will be set to have Open Sans Text with gray coloring and the text Edit Me. I'm going to show you how to change all of this. To start, I'm going to change the text color by clicking on this badge here and setting my text to be white. I'm then going to change the font. To change the font, simply open this font dropdown and choose which font you'd like to use. By default, there'll be over 900 fonts available via Google Fonts that you can choose for free. If you don't see the font that you need, you can always choose to upload your own custom font using this Upload Custom Font button. For more information on uploading custom fonts, I recommend you check out our deep dive video on adding text to a design. I'm also going to change the styling so that it is a light 300 style. To change the text itself, you can either double-click into the text box or click inline to switch to the inline editing mode. I'll now change the text to say celebrate coffee. I'm now going to change the size and position of this text box, and I wanted to highlight the two different ways you can do this. When you select the text box from the corner, resizing the text element will change the line breaks for the text within the text box, but leave the size of the text unchanged. Your second option is to select from an edge. Selecting from an edge allows you to quickly change the font size while leaving the line breaks unchanged. Using these two options, you can very quickly edit the size and position of your text to fit to your design canvas. I'm now going to add a second text box using the same Add Text button, and I'm going to edit this so that it can be used as a call to action button. Once again, I'm going to change the color of my text to be white. And in this case, I'm also going to add a background color. I'm going to make that background color a light green. Because I'm using this as a call to action button, I'm now going to move down to the text wrap settings and change it from wrapping words to not wrapping. Set it to don't wrap. And then I'm going to turn auto resize text box on. You'll notice that when I turn this option on, the text box has readjusted itself to fit directly around the edit me text. I can add padding here using these padding settings. So I'm going to set my left padding to be 20, my top padding to be 10, right 20, bottom 10. I'm also now going to add a border to the edges of this text box. So I'll change my border color to be transparent. And then to make it so I can see this border, I'll need to increase the width. So I'll increase this width to be 4 pixels. And you can see there's now this darker green that is going around the edge of the text element. I can also curl the edges by using this border radius option. If I add, say, a border radius, in this case of 19, you can see that I now have rounded edges on my text element. Same as before, I'll change the font to be Roboto with the light styling. If I change the text now, you'll notice that as I change it, the text element is adjusting its size to match the size of the actual text that is being put in there. I will also change the font size here to be slightly smaller than our previous version. I can now reposition these elements by just selecting all of them at the same time, all these left aligned elements, and aligning them as a group. Adding shapes. To add a shape to your design, open the Shapes panel on the left-hand side of the canvas, and then choose which shape you'd like to add and click on it. In this design, I'm going to be adding a circle. The first thing I'm going to do with this circle is change its layer position so that it's behind everything else in the design. So I'll go to the Layers panel, and then either by dragging and dropping it in the Layers panel or using these arrows, you can change its layer position. In this case, I'll click Send to Bottom to put it below all the other elements in the design. To make this a little easier to edit, I'm now actually going to zoom out on my canvas using these zoom options in the bottom right corner. I will now resize the element and reposition it so that it takes the far right side of the design, showing a half circle with half of it off the canvas. You can also change the color and the styling of this circle using the Shape Settings panel. I'm going to use the same green color as my call to action button. You can also add, similar to with the text element, a border with a different bordering width. Depending on the type of shape that you add to your design, these settings may change. I'm going to quickly click Center Canvas and click Fit to make it so I can see exactly what this will look like. If I'd like to remove the bounding boxes from each element and just see how it will look without those in place, I can hit Q on my keyboard as a keyboard shortcut, or under the More option, turn outlines on or off. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please email us at support@flexitive.com. You can also check out our other deep dive videos and the next Essentials video on animating your design. Until next time, thank you so much for watching and have a great day.